Hi guys, Darren from Aviation In Action. Welcome to this tutorial. Now before I do carry on, please do comment or subscribe. It's greatly appreciated. Today's tutorial is all about Flightradar 24. This is the world's most popular flight radar app. You can get it from Apple, the App Store, or you can get it from Android Player. This is real-time tracking of aircraft across the world. This is mainly used for civilian spotters. Please enjoy the tutorial. So here we do have the Flightradar 24 map, and I'm going to go through all the settings for you to make your experience using Flightradar 24 a fantastic one. So what we're going to do on the left hand side, I'm just going to go through here for you. Top toolbar, it says aircraft. And this basically gives you an idea on how many people are giving coverage at the present time. That gives you the symbols, basically. So here you can see on the ADSB, globally there's 12,205 people giving out data. In total, across the globe at the moment, there's 14,069 people giving data, which comes from a transponder of the aircraft. Next one below is airport delays. This shows you the delays in and around the globe. And if you want to, you can go to the delay map. But this will actually take you to the map of the areas that have delays. So anywhere that there is a delay, we can just press that and it will take us there. I'm not going to do that, but this what you do is just click here where it says go to delay map and it will take you to the airport where the delay is. It gives you the arrival and the departure. So arrival is 4.1 and departures are 5.0. Going down further, we have tweets, which is the Twitter page they supply. And then finally a blog post. There we go. And then finally underneath, it's where you can download the app. So you can download it on the App Store or Google Play. There you go. So moving across, we have apps. Apps, this will give you where you can get them. Like I said, download on the App Store or Google Play. If you reach this page, it gives you all the features. To get back to the map, go to the Flightradar 24 live traffic, click it, and it will take you back to the map. There we go. Add coverage. So if you have data that you wish to give, so if you've got the hardware that you wish to give data to the company, add coverage and you can apply for a receiver, share your data, etc. etc. Data and history, you go to airports, you can type in the airport. So for argument's sake, I will type in Heathrow, which is here. It will take me to Heathrow page and it will give you a nice map of the airfield, links to the airport website, a webcam if they're working, top routes that go out of Heathrow, the METAR. Now previously I mentioned the METAR, METAR data, so it gives you the data for the airfield itself. So looking at that, I know the winds are 240 at 12 knots, few clouds at 2,000 feet, scattered at 2,500, broken at 3,300, and then there's the QNH 1003. I will go through that in details at a later date, another tutorial. Down here you have the closest airports to the airfield. And on the right you have some arrivals. It tells you where they are. And then if you want to show all you can, and then you've got the departures below. And there's some nice reviews. That's the airports. You can singly go to the airline down here. Or you can actually go to the aircraft you'd like, which is here. Flights, so what aircraft airport do they come from, or what aircraft they go airport they go to, and it will give you the aircraft and flight number. And then number of tracked flights per day in the last 30 days. I'm going to go back. Then we go to the social media side. So they've got a blog, forum, newsletter, Facebook, Twitter, LinkedIn, Instagram, VK and Weeby. Press. So there you go, you can go for media inquiries. An about page, so about them, contact them, subscription plans, how it works, glossary, questions, careers, private policy and terms and conditions. And then you've got the commercial services, data services, app integration and aircraft unblocking. We're going to go back to the main map. And on the right over here, we have settings. Map style, you can change it to how you like. Flicking through them, but I personally like the terrain one. You can have different brightness. ATC boundaries. And again, this some of this stuff is not available on the basic. There is four different kind of subscriptions, which I will go through in a couple of minutes for you. Airport pin visibility. Airport pins, you can turn them off. And then you can have aircraft labels. You can have the registration number of the aircraft. You can have the call sign, etc., etc. You can have weather. You can have visibility. And you can have different bits and pieces. You can put the aircraft speed, the vertical speed, the wind speed, the altitude, etc. If you wish to go full screen, then it is in a full screen mode. You will have to pay for that extra. You can put filters in, so you can put the call sign here. So for argument's sake, if it was a British Airways aircraft, you'd probably put BA, blah, 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 blah. And then bookmark it. You can play back. You can zoom out and you can zoom in. That is basically what you can do. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to go through the map now for you and show you exactly what the map does do. So here we are, looking at the map over Heathrow Airport. Here's Heathrow, and we have this bit of advertisement. What you do again is right click it and it comes up with this. So you must remember, this will always come up if you right click it. So what we do is get rid of it. And then this one here, you see there's two over the corner here. Stop seeing this ad, not interested in the ad, and the ad will disappear. Once again, aircraft are using 27 left. So what we do is, I'll make that bigger for you. There you go. So you can see the aircraft coming in to Heathrow over the River Thames. Here we are, there's central London. And all we do is you click one aircraft, let's say, oh, there's one coming right over the top, so that's coming a bit fast. That one will be going over. There we go. So on the left-hand side, I've clicked the aircraft, it tells me it's CSA 663, which is Smart Wings on the left-hand side. You can't see it. Oh, let me move this around a little bit for you. There we go. There you go. So there's the aircraft. And there it is. So the information is here on the left. It's from Birmingham International off to Prague. Scrolling down, it's a Boeing 737, registration number, country. If you paid for the subscription, it will give you the age and the serial number, the altitude it's flying at, the speed it is, and latitude and longitude and squawk if you were paying for it. So click on a Heathrow one, It gives you the route that it's taken. Scrolling out, all the way out, and you can see where it's come from. So it's come from Madrid. Scroll back in. So there, so it's over London. And it's from Madrid. It is Iberia, going into London Heathrow. On this side here, you've got the scheduled departure time, the actual time it did depart, the scheduled arrival time into Heathrow, and what time is actually estimated to land. Here, you've got how many miles. So that's the distance it was from. How long ago? So that's an hour and 53 minutes. It's got 16 kilometers to go, and it's due to land in 4 minutes. Down here again, it's an Airbus A319. Registration number, it's come from Spain. Serial number, which is the manufacturing number. The age of the aircraft, its altitude, so it's at 2,400 feet. The vertical speed, the GPS altitude, and the tracking. They landed on 27. Speed, or ground speed of the aircraft, the true speed of the aircraft, indicated airspeed, the Mach, the wind, the temperature. Again, if you were paying for the silver or the gold, you would get all the information there. And again, you've got the bit code, the address, the squawk, and everything else. That is Flightradar 24. Quite easy to use. It doesn't just do jets, big jets, it also does small ones. So there's one there, it's a Gulfstream 5. Sometimes they don't put the routing on the commercial biz jets. They don't tend to put their flight plans out to be known, but there it is, it's a Gulfstream 5. It's at 14,000 feet. It also does little aircraft, so there's a Cessna. Not a Cessna, in actual fact, it's small enough to be a Cessna. What's up here? Oh, there we go. Cessna 152. So there's a Cessna 152. And they also do helicopters. So there's an Augusta 139. And again, it will show you the route it's come from. Normally comes out of Stansted, this one, or goes into Stansted. And there's another one, Top Cat 14. Augusta 109, Grand. So it does cover civilian, commercial airliners, private aircraft, biz jets, and helicopters. So this will cover everything that you need for your civilian spotting. Sometimes you do get a military now and again, not very often, but now and again you will. Now, the best one for military is the ADSB, which will be another tutorial, coming up very soon. I hope you've enjoyed the video. Please do comment. Please do subscribe. It's greatly appreciated. And I look forward to the next time. Take care. Bye-bye.